So this is one of the old interviews I found on one of the tapes back when I was working for the radio station, but definitely one of my favourite people, Dr. James Wright.
All right, so sitting here on the Gold Coast with Dr. James Wright. Good morning.
Hi, Togsy. Nice to talk to you and all your friends out there. Great crowd.
Now, can I ask a little bit about you? I mean, every great story starts with once upon a time.
Oh, once upon a time.
So where did the once upon a time story start for you? Whereabouts?
Oh, I live in my dad's eye, I think. I'm not sure. Long time ago. No, I've been around the place for a long, long time. One of three brothers. I have two brothers, one of three. And I was born in Brisbane, would you believe it? Yeah. And I've since travelled all over Australia, all over the world. But now I'm based basically Sydney and also the Gold Coast.
Right. Now, we just did some stuff on the radio this morning. I asked you about if it's something, being a doctor was something you always wanted to do. Was it really something you always were interested in?
No. In my day, had no choice. My mother was a very firm, iron woman. And she said, three boys, three doctors. No choice. That's what you do. Primary school, high school, university, doctor, and you try and be of some value in the world. That was Mum's ideal, and she's only one did it.
Right. Now, is it really hard? I mean, obviously, when kids are at school and you think about being a doctor, it's like six or something years of study, isn't it? I mean, was it really tough when you were doing it?
Yeah. Well, the answer was yes, it was very tough. And you either, in my day, you either had to get a good pass and win a scholarship and go to university, or alternatively, you went to the army, got your brain shot out. So it was no choice, mate. No choice.
So what's been like?
I faint at the sight of blood, so guns give me the horrors. So, right, so worked
what,
hard.
What would be a highlight of, say, a medical career then, if you could think of a couple? Is there like some really special moments for you in being a doctor that you've been really proud of it?
Actually, I always wanted to be a journalist, but so I became a medical journalist. I sort of pioneered the stuff years ago. I've been doing that. So I love all my patients. That's great. That's part A. Part B, doing radio, television, newspapers, books and stuff, which I also love. So I've combined it, two things that I really love doing.
Now, you talked about just then about travelling around a little bit. Where's some of the places you've been?
I just came back from Cuba the other day. Cuba, the Bahamas, Canada, Alaska. And you've got enough people all over the world who you know who they are. You go from there to there to there. I do this thing a couple of times a year, I guess, and go to medical conferences and try and learn how to become a good doctor after all these years. Togsy.
Okay, now, if you're just saying about, you know, being a doctor and being pushed into it by your mum, what would maybe be some other things you thought about doing?
Oh, well, when I was young, my dad was the chaplain of a large hospital. That means he looked after their spiritual needs and all this sort of stuff. So I had sort of a fairly intense Christian upbringing also, which is not real bad. And Dad said, when you guys get older, you should look after elderly people. Now, at the time, they got a rough deal. It's not too bad now. So about 30 years ago, my wife and myself set up a thing called Medi-Aid Foundation, which has started from nothing. Now it's quite big, and the aim is to look after elderly people, probably those who have got some chronic illness, and we provide accommodation for these people. We're looking after about 500 people now,
right,
on a very nice basis for them. It's a pretty good go. They get a very good go, and we care about them and look after them.
What about the young people? How do you see young people in today's society with health issues and stuff like that? I mean, obviously, it's a lot of fatty foods and stuff like that. Is that a concern for you?
The answer is yes. We're getting fatter and fatter, but all you see on television these days and reading the papers are the bad things, but you hardly ever read about the good things. Now, one of our retirement villages is next door to a very large high school in Sydney. It has 1,500 kids, and two or three times a year we go down there, listen to their choir sing, their band play, their orchestra play, and these kids are brilliant. Australia has more good kids than bad kids. So I've got no fears about the future of Australian kids. They are great kids. I love them all. They're terrific kids. Right. I mean that. Even blokes like you, dogs, even blokes like you, there is hope. Get what I mean?
A little bit of hope.
A little bit, mate, it's a huge bit. Because the kids today, and often the wilder kids, they become the pillars of society down the track, and they're the good kids.
Yeah.
Great kids.
Now, I ask a lot of people if they've either living their dream, if they're living their dream, or, you know, what their dream would be. So what is it for you? Have you found that you've lived your dream in what you've done, or what would be the ultimate dream for you if you could live it?
Oh, the early in life, you've got to decide what you want to do with your life. Well, Mum told us what to do, no doubts, with a few things, with a few alterations. So every January, every year, I sit down and have the last, as long as I can remember, written down all the things you want to do that year. Write them all down, 1 to 20 or whatever, and then you say, by December 31, these will all have been achieved. Date it, sign it, read it every night, and you bend over backwards to get all those things done.
That's good.
And then after, this has been going for nearly 40 years, mate.
Wow.
If you tick these things off, and what you don't achieve that year, you put on the next year. And looking back over many years, about that thick now, in the overall pattern, if you try hard, anyone, no matter who they are, you'll achieve 98% of those things. Have in mind what you're trying to do. So my advice to kids, write down what you want to do, work your backside off, enjoy it, have a lot of fun, go with your peers, go with your parents because they really care about you, and you'll make a success of your life, or you'll have a lot of fun in life.
Yeah. Well, Dr. James, you're a legend. Thank you very much for talking to me.
Lovely being here. Told you to see you all. Love you all.
Thank you.
Awesome. That's it.